This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
Live from the Civic Media World Headquarters in Madison, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Albaugh Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Albaugh.
Across Wisconsin on the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming worldwide on the Civic Media app. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Todd Albaugh, along with Mr. Aaron Zalmers on the board. It is 6 past the hour of 1 o'clock. Welcome into hour number 2 on the big program here on this Tuesday, November 19th, 2024. It is a great day to be Wisconsinite. Glad to have you along with us here. Overcast skies in the capital city. Many thanks to Luke Mathers for his Tuesday tangents with Lukester. You never know where it's going to go, and that's the beauty of the segment.
And it goes to such wonderful places.
The more unprepared, the better that segment goes. No, that's not true. That's partially
to
true.
Some degree. You have to have time.
You want some spontaneity, you understand?
Yes. You need at least a little bit of time set aside to just go wherever the tangents take you.
Right. That's what part of what makes that so great. We appreciate Luke being with us. He'll be back with us next Tuesday. Coming up this hour, want to talk a little bit about RFK Jr., Health and Human Services Secretary, the effect on vaccines and the perception of vaccines. Turns out they're pretty important. How might RFK Jr. affect all of that in American culture? Also monitoring current news, a couple of headlines for you quickly. Russia now apparently signaling that it is upping their response, or at least telling. A lot of this is signaling, you understand? Saber rattling. Saying that because President Biden authorized Ukraine to fire missiles into Russian territory to prevent the aggression from Russia, by the way. Now Russia is saber-rattling, saying, well, they're going to be on the ready now. They're ready to use nuclear weapons. Can't discount it. Putin, not a stable guy. Do I think it's going to happen? No. Because Putin's got Trump coming in a couple of months. So, you know, it would not make sense for him to blow everything up when he knows he's got Trump on the way in. But you never know. People are not necessarily stable there in the Kremlin. So we're following that news. Also, the Manhattan District Attorney just in said it would agree to postpone Donald Trump's sentencing to give them time to litigate the president-elect's expected motion to dismiss the hush money case. In a letter to Judge Juan Marchand, prosecutors said they will oppose Trump's motion to dismiss the case and suggest the judge set a deadline for the response of December 9th. Prosecutors said they don't oppose a stay of the proceedings since they would likely to be granted an appeal. Trump's lawyers are likely to file a response, and then the judge will respond or will decide what steps to take next. This has been, as Matt Flynn has told us on this program, this is Trump's modus operandi. He did it in private business for years. People would sue him, delay, delay, delay. And now he is delayed once again, hoping to be sworn in on January 20th. Well, he will be sworn in, but hoping that when that happens, that essentially all of his legal problems go away. So a seemingly apparent win today in court in the Manhattan case this afternoon. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. If you want to join the program this hour, go back to Joe, listening here at WMDX in Madison. Joe, always a pleasure. You wanted to go back to one of the subjects we talked about last hour, I believe, on this kind of intimidation of the media. We talked about this, the incoming FCC chairman, Brendan Carr, who is already on the commission, doesn't need to get confirmed. He's going to be the new chairman, is the chairman appointee, saying that he is looking at, He didn't use the word retribution. That's my word. But wants to investigate what happened at CBS and 60 Minutes. Jill, what have you got?
Wow, this is just amazing to me. If you want to check out the report, this is one news article. Title of it is "New Trump Sues CBS News Over 60 Minutes Interview with Harris. Network Says Suit Is Completely Without Merit." It's dated October 31, 2024. Mm. What fascinates me is how this is a campaign of fear. And you talked quite eloquently and elegantly about what you had been through in your experiences and really being left, you know, alone and isolated after standing up to what Walker and people had put you through. And I applaud what you've done, and I hope you return to this story and expand on it and let people know more details, because I find it fascinating. You were all alone. CBS News at least has a very solid legal department behind it. But one of the things I found interesting when going through this and looking at this one article, people have talked that Trump is looking for $10 billion from the network, and people have used the words that he was defamed. He was not defamed. In the what he cites is not defamation. This is not a defamation case. Instead, this suit is trying to have a novel use of a Texas statute that's meant to protect advertisers from misleading the public about a product. The act that they're suing under is, get this, Todd, it's unbelievable, the Texas Deceptive Trade Practices Consumer Protection Act.
Wow.
What?
Wow.
I mean, what?
Right?
Where are they taking it? They're taking it to a federal court in the Northern District of Texas Amarillo Division. This is the same place where one lone judge, 2019 Trump appointee, there have been a total of 14 different political sensitive cases that have gone to that particular court, because they know this guy's under control. They know right. They can make him spin and dance the way that they want him to. Mm. So this is not a case about defamation. This is instead trying to stir the pot, trying to make CBS look bad, trying to say they have edited things so that I look bad. Come on. I mean, how many interview subjects would say, you know, you made me look bad? Get over it. You mm-hmm. agreed to the interview. You're handed a release before you do an interview that tells you that they will edit what happens. I mean, you don't just walk in and say, I'd like to see the tapes, and then you and I together will edit the show. Are you kidding me?
Correct.
That's never, ever happened. You know, the tapes for the interview belong to CBS News, and you signed a release. If you didn't want to do an interview, don't sign a release. So I just found this amazing. It's not even about defamation. Mm. It is what is applied for Consumer Protection Act. So, you know, check it out. It is amazing because it gives you some idea of what kind of machinations are ahead. They are planning to go on a campaign against journalists, and this just tells you what obscure practices and obscure judges are going to be used to start this campaign. Thanks a lot, Todd. Appreciate the chance to talk.
Appreciate you, Joe. Thank you so much, Joe. Always coming with facts and really, really appreciate the clarity on that story, because I had not seen that part of it, Joe. I had not seen that what he was doing is going through, what they were doing is going through this court in Texas. And to Joe's point, at the end of the day, it really isn't about the defamation, right? It's about what we talked about a little bit last hour in part, which is fear. And to put the fear of God, to use a phrase, into reporters, into news organizations, that if you cross us, if you say something, report something that we don't like, regardless of whether it's accurate or the truth, or even protected by law, we will come after you, and we will use the court system to cost you a lot of money and time and intimidate you. And we, meaning the Trump Organization, control all access to the president and government officials, by the way. You have a hurricane in your community? You want to talk to the director of FEMA? Hey, if you're not reporting what we like, good luck on that. And these news organizations know that if they don't have access, it's not just Trump. It's the federal government. It's going to make it remarkably hard to get news and information that their listeners, readers want to hear and see. So a lot of this, Joe is right, is about intimidation. And how many times did we hear from folks during the campaign? Well, it won't be that bad. Project 2025, it's not real. And, well, the courts will stop it. Those have been the guardrails, or part of the guardrails, right? To Joe's point, they're very nuanced in this. You know, the Trump folks are not all just unintelligent people. Many of them are very intelligent, actually, and know how to work and maneuver things. And they're finding this friendly court, apparently, in Texas to do this one on CBS. If the law is followed, it should be thrown out. Any legit judge would just say, this is dismissed. It's crazy, to Joe's points. But you find one friendly judge. Hey, maybe this guy wants to, you know, get a higher appointment. Whatever. And this is exactly, Trump has a history of rewarding those who are loyal to him. But it's about the intimidation and going after people. And we know six judges on the Supreme Court, the conservatives, in that ruling earlier this year, essentially gave Trump, or if you apply it literally, any sitting president, next to carte blanche, as long as it can be justified as an official act of the president of the United States. So I don't mean to, you know, cause people heartache and heartburn and get everybody all ginned up. I just think it's important, as Joe laid out factually, to know the facts. This is not a time to, I know the tendency is to say, I just want to turn it all off and not pay attention. And look, we all need to take a break for mental health reasons. But we can't, in my opinion, completely just tune out, because we need to be an informed electorate as we have a state Supreme Court race coming up in Wisconsin this spring. A state school superintendent race coming up. There are going to be state races in 2 years. Again, for state assembly, state senate, the midterm, Congress. And to tune out and say we're not going to try to continue to find the truth is just being an ill-informed electorate, and that does nobody any good, in my opinion. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842, if you would like to join the program. Always a pleasure. We'll keep updating you on, again, the Manhattan DA this afternoon agrees to postpone Trump's sentencing in the hush money case until the appeals process plays out. I guess not a surprise at this point, nor was it unexpected. Speaking of court cases, going to want to stick around after our show. The fantastic Maggie Dawn going to be covering this story about Justice Gableman coming up next hour. She will break that down for you, bring you a great guest as well. The Maggie Dawn Show going to have on Law Forward General Counsel Jeff Mandel today at 3 p.m. on the Maggie Dawn Show. So don't miss that, coming up immediately after hours. Phone calls and more after this. It's the Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
Truth, wherever it may lead, and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. Now 21 past the hour of 1 o'clock. Glad to have you along. Going to take a look here at RFK Jr., what it might mean for him to be the Secretary of Health and Human Services. But first, let's go to the phone lines. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Jim in Brookfield. Jim, thanks for listening to us. I assume on WAUK. You wanted to follow up a little bit more on these lawsuits regarding the media. Go ahead.
Right. I just want to say, Todd, that you're spot on that Trump and the Republicans will use the process as the punishment to go after the media, use the court system, even though they know that there's no merit to the case that they're going to file. It's the process that they're going to use as a punishment, even though it's going to be dismissed eventually or, you know, ruled in the favor. That happened right here in Milwaukee when the RNC went after the Milwaukee Election Commission right before the election.
Right.
You know, and they admitted, oh, yeah, there's no merit to that. And then wasn't there a Republican legislator from Wisconsin who went after some smaller media market? I believe it was in Wausau. Again, there was no merit to that.
Correct.
You know, and they are using weaponizing the judicial system, the court system, with or without favorable judges, you know, with a favorable judge all the worse, but they're using the court system, weaponizing it. And again, the term is the process is the punishment. They're very good at it, and they want to just drain somebody. And when other people see that happening to their colleagues, they're intimidated.
Correct. No, great call, Jim. Really appreciate the call, the follow-up there. You're right. So much of it is about intimidation. And, hey, if you get out of line, you're going to feel it one way or the other. You might not be locked up, you know, the locker up stuff. That might not happen. But we will make your life a living hell on earth using the federal government, in this case, to audit you, to come after you, to investigate you, to break you financially, right? Think about how much money this takes people, and especially smaller news organizations, to defend themselves. I mean, CBS is a big corporation, but still, it's not going to be cheap. You're right. It is retribution, and we'll continue to follow this. All right. Last August, Robert F. Kennedy Jr. dropped his independent campaign for president and endorsed Donald Trump. In return, Trump promised Kennedy a role in his administration where he could, quote unquote, run wild with his alternative health ideas. On November 14th, Trump completed the deal by picking Kennedy to be Secretary of Department of Health and Human Services, better known as DHHS. A couple of Wisconsin, famous Wisconsin people, by the way, have served in that role. Donna Shalala, under former President Barack Obama. Donna Shalala, longtime chancellor of the University of Wisconsin, really turned this university's sports programs around, hired Barry Alvarez, or got him to be the head football coach, turned it all around, and then went down and worked at the University of Miami, where she is, I believe, originally from, was the president down there as well. But Donna Shalala served as DHHS secretary and also, of course, former Republican Governor Tommy Thompson under George W. Bush in the same role. And now Trump appointing Kennedy to that office. RFK Jr. is 70 years old, has for decades promoted conspiracy theories and disinformation. He's a vaccine skeptic, spreading the thoroughly debunked link. Try that again, Todd. Spreading the thoroughly debunked link of vaccines and autism. In Kennedy's world, correlation equals causation. And government and big corporations are in on it, whatever it is. DHHS includes the Food and Drug Administration, Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, National Institutes of Health, and the Center for Medicare and Medicaid. This is not a small agency. Kennedy is an environmental lawyer with no, zero, zilch background in science, research, or medicine. He has no experience operating levers of government or administering a big organization. DHHS has a staff, get this, of 83,000 people. And its budget is nearly a quarter of our entire national budget. Opinions from Kennedy, or on Kennedy rather, run the gamut. From he would break the prime rule of medicine, first do no harm. He will transform our quote-unquote sick care industry and save millions of lives, especially our children, by ending the threats of ultra-processed food and toxic chemicals. That's another take. And I've said on the show, look, I'm not against looking into some of these ultra-processed foods. But is that worth jettisoning our entire vaccination plan? I don't think so. Another take out there on Kennedy is his junk science will put every American at risk. Another take? He's a good talker and says things that quote-unquote sound smart, but are actually dangerously wrong. Kennedy has transformed from a left-wing skeptic to a far-right populist, and that has made him a frequent and popular guest of podcasters. YouTube hosts, and other alternative media known as the Manosphere. Have you heard this term? How long has it been out there, Zombers?
Manosphere? Yeah. I mean, it's the concept itself has existed for a while. The term probably only for 4 or 5 years, maybe.
I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, it's the online equivalent of the man cave.
Yeah, it's just echo chambers of men being manly. Right. Like, don't wipe your butt, that's gay.
That's actually a thing. You're not making that up. That's
correct.
Actually...
That's not widespread in all of it, but I have
gross.
Seen it there.
Which is just gross and ridiculous, but anyway. But thank you. So the Manosphere is a real thing. Manosphere hosts combine both right and left arguments. That's what makes it both powerful, in my opinion, but also extraordinarily confusing. They have succeeded in attracting disaffected followers with a mix of sports, pop culture, humor, and politics. The Manosphere populist message is about defenders of free thinking battling corporate and deep state elites that censor free speech. Think Aaron Rodgers. He is deep in the Manosphere, right? Popular in sports, somewhat pop culture. Some people like his humor. But he also has these very kind of far out takes on health and vaccines and immunizations. Want to come back, talk about this more on the other side, take your phone calls as well. These are the dangers when you put populists in charge of actual responsibility. 855-752-4842. It's the All Ball Show on Civic Media.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
Yeah, pursuing truth wherever it may lead and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Tyler Ball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It is now 34 minutes past the hour of 1 o'clock. Glad to have you along on a Tuesday. Aaron Zommer's on the board. If you want to join the conversation, 855-752-4842. 855-752-4842. You can also text us on the Civic Media app. If you don't have it, go to your Apple or Android device. Type in Civic, C-I-V-I-C, Media. It'll pop up. Takes less than a minute to download. It is free, the Civic Media app. Right now, talking about RFK Jr., Robert Fitzgerald Kennedy Jr. being appointed as Secretary of Department of Health and Human Services, and what some of the outcomes may be. Again, passing this along to you to think about this, to be prepared, be aware, and also trying to understand how we came to this point. That a guy who's never really worked in government, never really run a big corporation, never controlled, anywhere close to the amount of people, 83,000 employees that DHHS has, gets put in this position of responsibility by Trump. And pointing out the fact that a lot of this has been perpetuated by far-right populists. But Kennedy has really gone from that left-wing skeptic to a far-right populist. And been a frequent guest on podcasters, YouTubes, and known as the Manosphere. And the Manosphere, what makes it both dangerous and powerful, is that it's not just one-sided in the traditional sense. It combines both right and left arguments. And they have succeeded in attracting disaffected followers with a mix of sports, pop culture, humor, and politics. The Manosphere world out there online and podcasts and streaming and all, it's not just a politics show. Like Joe Rogan, it's entertainment. The experience, right? And the Manosphere populates a message It's about defenders of free thinking battling corporate and deep state elites that censor free speech. I mean, think about that for a minute. They're going after the quote-unquote rich folks out there. So it's not all about supporting the wealthy. It's more about, hey, we're defending free thinking. Deep state elites that are kind of like conspiracy theories. And, you know, people love a good conspiracy theory. And saying, look, nobody has a right to tell you you can't say what you want to say.
And importantly, they use that to encourage you to demean women. And it's, you can say whatever you want to say as long as you're a man.
Right. All under this machismo type of thing.
Yeah.
Interestingly, since RFK Jr.'s nomination, mainstream media's coverage has pivoted from his vaccine ideas to his views on obesity, diabetes, nutrition, and processed foods. Super interesting, right? And this ties back in with what we were talking about in hour one, the intimidation of legacy media. Not hearing a lot of people talk about right now what we're talking about. His actual ideas on vaccine. Oh, well, you know, he wants to fight obesity. Great. He wants to help out diabetes. Great. He wants to take on processed foods. Great. It's the normalization that makes this dangerous. Some media sources even portray Kennedy as an averaging hero for public or avenging hero for public health, out to ban the chemicals, pollutants, pesticides, pharmaceuticals, and food additives sickening and killing Americans, especially our kids. Come on, who wouldn't want to, you know, be in favor of that? All of these battles would be waged with corporations and interest groups with lots of lobbyists and lawyers. The same ones that contribute very generously to election campaign funds. The battles RFK Jr. wants are not the battles that most politicians want, which is to say that a confirmation hearing for Kennedy ought to be a doozy. Here's if he gets to a hearing, which I think he probably will be. We'll see. Is he going to be asked about these things? At different points in his career and his life, Kennedy has been an AIDS denier. Saying, well, it really isn't a virus. You know, just completely illegitimate, proven wrong things on HIV and AIDS. Is he going to be asked about his belief on the record that he believes that Wi-Fi causes cancer? Will he be asked about blaming school shootings on antidepressants? How about Kennedy's claim that the CIA assassinated his uncle, President John Fitzgerald Kennedy? Will he be asked about his belief that pleading guilty to felony heroin possession in South Dakota 40 years ago? And most important, will Kennedy be asked if his healthy diet agenda extends to fast food burgers and fries? And will his answer prompt Donald Trump to withdraw his nomination on the spot? Because we know that Trump loves McDonald's. If Kennedy's coming after McDonald's, it could be pulled. That could be the seal the deal thing.
Yeah, I don't know what he'll do because there's that picture of them on a plane recently eating McDonald's, and Trump looks happy as all get out, and RFK Jr. looks like he would rather be literally anywhere else.
Yes. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Driving on the roads, or are you parked? To Gary down in Sussex, we appreciate you listening. Gary, what say you?
Well, this is what I think. I think our country has one of the highest for a country that's as big as ours, diabetes, cancer, and everything else. So nobody has tackled this problem with the chemicals in the food until now. Now, is RFK Jr., is he qualified to be this Secretary of Health and Human Services and all that sort of stuff? Probably not. But he's the only candidate that's willing to go out there and try something. So for the next 4 years, why not give it a shot? You know, I eat bad. but I've been trying to eat better. And I buy organic celery and organic apples and stuff like that. Why not? They're not going to use chemicals in it. Why not? Try
yeah,
it. I'm 72. It's almost too late.
No, never too late. Don't say that, Gary. No, yeah, I mean, look, I mean, there's an area of agreement. I've talked to this show before. I buy organic Valley milk because it doesn't have the BGH hormones, and my body reacts better to organic Valley milk. I don't buy everything organic, but I do buy my butter and my milk organic. And for my body, it makes me feel better when I eat those things. And I don't think anybody is, well, I shouldn't say anybody. I'm certainly not saying that's a bad thing to take on processed foods. But to the point, Gary, is that I think that too many people are focusing on that portion of it and are ignoring what I'm going to go into next, which are that this guy is just completely proven wrong when it comes to vaccines and autism. And that's dangerous. That's dangerous when we start telling kids and parents that don't get your kids vaccinated because they might get autism. That could kill a kid. I mean, I don't know, Gary, did you get vaccinated as a kid? I'm 55. I did.
Yeah, I did. I got my vaccinations and my grandkids got all vaccinated. Now, I never did get the COVID back, and I had COVID twice. The first time I had it, I was really sick. Right. I mean, really sick.
Well,
I had it, I barely was sick. Yeah.
But let's put the COVID, because I know that's, I don't want to get into the COVID vaccine right now. I certainly believe in it. I think it's fine. But let's go back to rubella, measles, polio. I mean, I'm assuming you got your, if you were vaccinated for those things, I'm assuming you got your kids vaccinated for those things, and have somebody at the top of that administration and a national platform telling new parents, hey, you know what? That polio vaccine might give your kids autism. I think that's extraordinarily irresponsible.
I didn't get autism. I can remember back when I got my vaccination. If I remember right, they put a drop on a sugar cube, and that was like polio. And then the smallpox, they scratched my arm. I have this sore. I still have that scar. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I was vaccinated.
Yeah. So I think that's what I'm talking about here. It's and I think this is the point of going through this, that too much of the media is spending time on maybe a couple of the things that I could go along with RFK on, like taking on processed foods or whatever. But they're not spending time on what he really believes and is on the record saying of being spreading, not just having a belief, but literally spreading lies and misinformation about vaccines. And I think that's dangerous. But I appreciate the call, Gary. 855-752-4842. Let's go to Charles in Milwaukee, listening to WAUK. Thank you, Charles, for calling in. What say you?
Hey, good afternoon, Todd. I'm worried about that as well with RFK as far as vaccine. I have a niece right now that won't get her son vaccinated because she heard somewhere along the way that, you know, vaccines cause autism.
Mm-hmm.
So that is very scary. And I just wanted to push back on Gary real quick as far as the no one else has tackled eating healthy. Michelle Obama talked about it, and she was crucified when she said, you know, the kids should be feeding our kids healthier foods at school. And question, why are we selling big gulp drinks that are sugary at gas stations? And so somebody tried to have that talk.
No, you're absolutely right. She planted an organic garden, I think, at the White House, and she was ridiculed by the right Republicans. Made fun of.
By the right.
Yeah, exactly.
Talking about, don't take my fries. If I want to be fat from eating French fries, let me be fat. I mean, and I'm all for changing our food habits in this country. But there are other things, like you said, that we should be worried about when it comes to RFK Jr. Yeah.
Really appreciate the call, Charles. Thank you for listening down there in beautiful Milwaukee. 855-752-4842. Cam in Appleton. Cam, thanks for calling in. What say you?
Bear with me just for this one sentence. It has to do with Gary.
Okay.
I replaced the heat exchanger on an RTU and drove a screw into the first stage condenser coil when putting the panels back on and dumped 25 pounds of R22. I'm just trying it out because no one has ever really tried it out before. And I'm confident that something will happen. I want you to sleep on that, buddy.
I'm not even sure what that all means, but go ahead. Quickly.
Sorry. RFK is a threat to everything that I know in my life. My partner has an immune system that's completely shut off from medication that she needs. We feel bad to even like go anywhere for dates. It sucks. It's not fair. Mm. And on top of that, he wants to, I'm not joking when I say this, but he wants to send people that are on medications like Vyvanse and Adderall to labor camps to try to help them get over their ADHD. ADHD is not this made up thing that a lot of people seem to get in their head. It's literally like you have parts of your brain that are underdeveloped. Mm-hmm. It is not something that you can just go to camps for. I'm not going to a labor camp. I'm not going to milk your cows just because you guys kicked out the Mexicans.
Right. I appreciate it, Cam. Thank you so very much. 855-752-4842. Let's go quickly to Carol. Carol, about a minute left. It's all yours. What do you say?
I'd like to talk about RFK Jr. and how he is responsible for the deaths of 83 people, most of them children, in Samoa from measles because of his anti-vax BS. Mm-hmm. I'm terrified that he's going to make polio great again. And another thing, I can't wait till the Manosphere realizes that Project 2025 is going to ban porn. I am just living for that. I'm living for that.
Right? That's a great point. Somebody else brought up in the text. Thank you, Carol.
Or that was Carol who brought it up.
All right, Carol. Thank you very much. No, it's true. In the 900 pages of Project 2025, one of the things that they want to do with the Heritage Foundation and the Trump transition team is ban porn. I'm just saying, if you're in the Manosphere, that might not sit real well. But we'll see. Going to come back, finish up these thoughts. What we know about how vaccines and autism are not linked and why Robert Kennedy is a dangerous appointment. Don't go anywhere. It's the Todd Allball Show for a Tuesday, right here on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Welcome back to the Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. Glad to have you along. 9 now before the hour of 2 o'clock. Coming up at the top of the hour, ABC or CBS News, depending upon which radio station you are listening to across the network in the great state of Wisconsin. Partner, no place you can not get us, to use a triple negative. All across the state of Wisconsin, what makes this great network so wonderful? Listening for people up in along the Lake Superior skyline, too, but the shoreline down to Lake Michigan, over to the Mississippi River, up to Green Bay, and all places in between. Glad to have you along with us. So then after that news update, little sports, little weather, Maggie Dawn from 2 until 4. Today, Wisconsin's Office of Lawyer Regulation filed a complaint against former Wisconsin Supreme Court Justice Michael Gableman, moving on a grievance filed by Law Forward. Today, Maggie is going to be interviewing Law Forward General Counsel Jeff Mandel today at 3 p.m. Not going to want to miss it. The Maggie Dawn Show every afternoon from 2 until 4, followed by Dom Selvia's show, and then Pete Schwabba, Rick Smith Across America, and Robert Pilot with Native Roots Radio. A great lineup once again here on the Civic Media Radio Network. Want to get to this. Following up. And by the way, I keep saying Robert Fitzgerald Kennedy. I get caught up sometimes. Thank a listener, Tom, listening in, corrected me. It's Robert Francis Kennedy. Sorry about that, folks. But still RFK. But yes, you are correct. Robert Francis Kennedy Jr. A belief in a link of vaccines and autism is ill-founded, not just ill-founded, wrong. Jill Eisker is a writer who covers autism. She also has two children impacted by profound autism. In her piece in the Free Press, Eisker provided 5 compelling arguments on how we know that autism is not caused by vaccines. Let me say that again. How we know that autism is not caused by vaccines, as Robert F. Kennedy Jr. often insinuates or just says outright. Number one, we know that a hallmark of autism is dysregulation of brain development starting in the prenatal period. Number two, childhood immunizations simply cannot explain what goes wrong during gestation. Number three, there is not a single ingredient in vaccines that can cause childhood brain development to go awry. And no animal study shows links between vaccines and the abnormal brain development seen in autism. Number four, there is no plausible reason vaccines could explain autism's strong heritability. In other words, sharply increased incidence among siblings. Or its strong male-to-female ratio of about 4-1. Also, vaccine schedules cannot possibly explain the steadily accelerating rates over time. And finally, and most importantly, every epidermal study on the topic has confirmed zero association between vaccines status and the development of autism.
I have another important one too.
Yes.
So the people who are anti-vaxxers are saying, if you have a child, you would rather that they die of polio than develop autism. So even if it were linked, which it categorically is not, that's what you're implying.
Mm. No, it's, and again, I'm all for studies. I'm all for science. I'm all for, hey, if you believe something is this way, if it could be proven not, hey, that's progress. But there's been no credible scientific study that proves a link between vaccines and autism. And for Robert Kennedy to be spreading outright lies about this, as we said before the break, it's putting particularly kids and elderly folks at risk. Their lives at risk. And again, I'm willing to separate out for argument purposes or just to get to a place where we can agree. I'm willing to separate out COVID vaccines. I personally get the vaccine. I personally believe it's useful. I personally believe it saved hundreds of thousands, not millions of lives. But let's set that one aside for a moment. Without talking about the COVID vaccine, does America really want to be at a place where we no longer immunize our kids for polio, rubella, measles, mumps, chickenpox? Do you really want to risk putting your kids and grandkids in a position where they now contract those diseases? Our hospitals are overwhelmed, and we got a taste of that during COVID. Remember the freezer trucks sitting outside of hospitals as makeshift morgues? Those are the things I wish that our legacy media was talking about more. Not just glossing over and saying, well, Robert Kennedy, I mean, he's all for taking on big pharma. He's all for taking on processed foods. And those things might be true. I'll give him that. But the question is the trade-off for that worth putting millions of lives at risk? I don't think so. And that's why we need qualified people in this new cabinet. That's why we need U.S. Senate confirmation hearings so that we can suss out these things that we've been talking about for the last hour. Information, real news, great conversations. Somebody should make that into a slogan. Oh, wait, they did at Civic Media. Mr. Zalmers, thanks to you. Thanks to Luke Mathers for a great edition of Tuesday Tangents at Lukester. All the great callers, we appreciate you so very much all across Wisconsin and around the nation. Stay tuned. Maggie Dawn is next. Whatever you're fighting for, whatever you believe in, do not give up. Keep banging your drum. See you tomorrow.
The national news cycle never stops.
but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.